Hey friends, it's Tess. This is Wander Wealthy, and today I wanted to show you how I use my bullet journal to plan and keep track of my months. So I have been using a bullet journal to keep track of my schedule and notes and pretty much everything else that I needed to take pen and put it on paper for. And I've been doing this since June of 2017. I learned about bullet journaling through probably YouTube, and I just saw that it was a way to essentially make your own planner or scheduler or daily tracker. And I loved the creativity that is involved in a lot of people's bullet journals. You'll find that mine is much more of a minimalist approach, mainly because I have no artistic capabilities. But I also loved that you had full control over what was in your journal. I've seen a ton of different journals that have certain things that are useful and certain things that I just don't use. And I really wanted to just create my own, and bullet journaling was the best and easiest and almost fastest way to do it. If you want to learn more about the actual bullet journaling method, then I will link the video tutorial of the guy who created bullet journal down below. Also, I am using the type of bullet journal I use is the bullet journal brand, but it's in partnership with the brand Luktern 1917. So again, I will link this type of bullet journal that I am specifically using down below, but essentially you can find any kind of notebook that's out there on the market that has dot pages, pages that have dots in them. It's just a dot journal, so you don't necessarily have to buy this specific bullet journal by Luktern. You can just buy any dot journal and then put your own spreads, is what they call them, inside. Now, before I open up my bullet journal to you, I just want to remind you, if you're new to my channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button plus the little bell. I upload new videos on a weekly basis all about personal growth, personal finance, and travel. And if you're noticing that you're liking this video, make sure you hit that thumbs up button, because it helps me know that I should make more videos about journaling or organization or other fun things that relate to this video. All right, so let's dive in. When you bullet journal, you typically create new spreads for every day or every week or every month. And I choose to do it on a monthly basis. And I have a couple of different spreads that I use. I've used different ones throughout the past months and found that some things work for me and some things don't. And that's what I really love about bullet journaling in general, is you can switch it up every month if things change. Now, some people create daily spreads for just one day, and that will go across the entire sheet. I create a monthly spread that has the month's calendar, and then I go in and create weekly layouts that are for every single week of the month. And then any notes that I take within that month go either before or after that entire section for the days of the month that are spread out by weeks. It's different for everyone. Some people like to categorize and organize their monthly notes, things that happen throughout the month or throughout the week, by separating them between the days of the week or the weeks of the month that they are scheduling out and putting in their bullet journal. But this is specifically how I do it. So first I'll just kind of parse out the number of pages that I need for my entire month. And in this video, you're seeing me set up the month of March. I don't typically leave blank pages between my spreads, but if I do think that there's gonna be a couple of phone calls that I might have or a couple of brainstorming sessions, then I will leave a blank page before I start the next month, because I'm anticipating creating some notes for the previous month. So I save 2 pages for my business content calendar and my goals and stats. And I'll give you a quick brief look, but I'll show you a zoomed in look on these 2 pages. On one side of the journal, I'll create a content calendar, and I typically upload videos on Tuesdays and Fridays, and I'm always leaving a spot for Sundays, even though I rarely upload videos there, just in case I have an extra video for that week. So I create the days of the month that fall on Tuesdays and Fridays, and then I'm able to put in some tabs, some of these sticky notes, which then indicate what type of video I'm posting. So as I've mentioned many times on my channel before, I talk about personal development or growth, trying to be a better person professionally or personally. Also, personal finance, so talking all about money, and then I like to talk a lot about travel. Each of these different sticky notes or tabs represents a different topic. The lighter yellow is the personal development, the darker yellow is money, and the orange is travel. So that helps me get a good idea when I look at this calendar from just an overview perspective that I am kind of hitting on different topics throughout the month. So I'm mixing it up a little bit for my audience. Any ideas I'll just put below, and that helps me with any sort of brainstorming. And if I have an idea randomly, but it doesn't quite fit in this calendar, I put it down there and I can always roll things over from the previous month. In February, I had a ton of ideas that were posted, but then I also have a bunch of excess ideas here. And so I will most likely move these over to March when I get a little bit more organized as I get further into the month. On the other page are my goals and stats tracker for that month. Whether you are tracking information for your own business, for your own blog or YouTube channel or whatever, or you're tracking information for your health and fitness, your money goals, your personal development or professional goals, whatever it is, you could easily create this goals and stats tracker for yourself to make sure that you are staying on track. And what I really use this for is at the top, I write three business goals that I want to have. And usually they're things that I can accomplish on a weekly basis or on a daily basis. And it's not necessarily a big goal or even a 3-month goal. And I've talked a lot about how I go through goal setting, but these are more this tiny goals that are more like sprints, small things I need to do every day or week in order to make sure that I'm hitting that bigger end goal after 3 months. I also have personal goals below my stats tracker. Those are things that I personally want to get better at and improve at. And so again, they're not necessarily big goals. A big goal would be to become fluent in Italian, but a personal sprint or task that I want to accomplish on a weekly or daily basis is to practice Italian 20 minutes every day. Then I go into the stats tracker, and this is primarily for my business. I'm really tracking the numbers of my YouTube growth, my Facebook group engagement and growth, as well as my email list, and then members that are involved in my program so I can keep track of new members and percentage of growth. So I have it all across. I put the date of every Friday down the side so that every Friday I have a ritual where I sit down and I update these numbers, and I can visually see week after week after week of that month how I am advancing. And then I can look back at February and really see how I've grown since then and even previous months. I've done it for every month since June. On the next page of my monthly layout, I have the monthly calendar, and this is new. I've really struggled with the idea of having this slice in the middle of the calendar, but I needed a one-shot glance at my monthly calendar, so I decided to start drawing them out here just because it would really help me visualize the entire month instead of each individual week. So I drew out the monthly calendar, and then on the side here, I put my habit tracker. This is a good one to include for those tiny habits that you're trying to advance, and they aren't necessarily related to your goals, but they can be. I have some business and some personal habits that I want to make sure I'm doing on a daily basis. And so every day that I do them, I put the days of the month across the top, and then I just fill in each square every day I end up doing each of these habits. I'll mark in morning gratitude, drinking 16 ounces of water in the morning, meditating in the morning, practicing my Italian, which does relate to my goal, working out, which also relates to one of my personal goals, reading for 15 minutes, flossing, a basic daily habit that I'm just trying to make sure I do every day, washing my face, drinking 16 ounces of water in the evening, and doing evening gratitude. So again, basic daily habits that I'm trying to make sure that I'm doing every day, and seeing this entire block filled in and seeing where there are gaps are a really good way for me to pay attention to what's going on in my life. Then we get into the actual days of the week. I finished on a Sunday in my February spread on the 4th, so now I'm just starting this new monthly spread on the 5th of March. And I just divide out how many boxes need to be for each day, and I just start filling filling out the actual structure of this weekly planner. And then within each week, I really just put some big things that might be happening. So I know when I need to launch a video. I also have some events coming up, so I know that I need to fill those in throughout. And this is also where I get into my money tracking. As most people who follow me for quite a long time, I am the anti-budgeter. I have a special budgeting methodology that is for people who budgets haven't worked for them in the past so well. And it's called the anti-budget. You can click up here to learn more about that. But there's many ways that you can track your anti-budget, whether you physically pull out your daily number in cash, or you just track it through an Excel spreadsheet, or you're like me and you use good old pen and paper to track your daily number. That is what I do. And so I make a little section in my weekly spread to track my daily number. So I'll just put the daily number in the upper corner. And then as I spend throughout that day, I'll mark down the dollar amount that I've spent so that at the end of the day, I have whatever is left over and I can move it to the next day. That next day starts with that same daily number. So all I have to do is add whatever was left over, whether it's a positive or a negative number. I add it to the next day's daily number. And that's what I get to start with for my daily spending money for that day. And it just keeps going throughout the week. I might mark what's left over at the end of the week in the bottom corner, and then I will move it to the next week. And once I get to the end of the month, that is how much I know I can put towards my savings or put towards my debt or use to splurge on something that I personally wanted throughout the month, and now I have the money to pay for it. Bullet journaling, they actually give you some ways to track your tasks or what you have going on throughout the day, and they show that in the key. Now, here's what I actually do. Pretty much, I'll do a dot for things that I have to do and a circle for meetings that I have. Once I finish them, I put a cross through the dot or the circle, and if I end up canceling it altogether, I'll just put an X straight through it. Or if I want to advance it to the next day, then I'll do that open caret where I do the greater and symbol away from the actual task itself, and that means I migrate it to the next day or sometime in the future. That's pretty much the only ones that I use, and it's entirely up to you. You can create your own key, and it's just what works for you. That's what bullet journaling is all about. And then the only other thing I do is leave a couple of pages for notes or collections at the end of my monthly spread. And this happens naturally because I don't start planning for the following month until the last week of this month. So I do have room to make notes and make sure that that is all organized. And then I know, okay, I remember making these notes about this specific thing. What month was it in? And I can go find it. But another thing you can do with bullet journaling is you typically have an index. Now you need to keep this up to date in order for it to work pretty well. I have not kept mine up to date as well, but if I ever need to or I feel motivated and inspired, I could always go in here and finish writing this out, and that would be really helpful for me once I close out this bullet journal, but know that I have some really good ideas in here that I want to flip back to. So that is how I set up my bullet journal for monthly success, to make sure that I'm staying on track with my goals, that I'm staying on task with the things that I have to do throughout the weeks or the months, and that I can keep up with my monthly anti-budget and my daily spending number. I hope this was helpful for you all. If you liked it, make sure you give it a thumbs up. I will create more videos about how I stay organized and how I use my bullet journal, because it does change every couple months as I learn new things about myself or I just see certain things working and not working. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to my channel because I upload new videos similar to this on a weekly basis, and come join the Wealthy Wanderers private Facebook community. If you feel like this is a thing that you want to learn more about, or you want to surround yourself with people who are also working through their own personal development, personal finance, and travel goals just like you, then join the group, because there's nothing better than surrounding yourself with a group of women who just get it. Go to wanderwealthy.com/FB to learn how you can get involved. And until I see you in there or in the next video, I hope you wander wealthy.